Happy birthday.
Josh,
get him. Chase him.
I'm drinking something. I sweat. Oh my god.
Boy.
Okay, this is kind of weird. I never record. There's like, I don't know if anybody's even around. I don't think anybody's around. I'm in a parking garage. I'm like excited and I don't know. Oh, I'm in the parking garage from, gosh, I'm in the parking garage at my doctor's office, just getting ready to leave. I'm done with my appointment, but I just wanted to video really fast so that I don't forget everything that he just told me. I did video in the actual appointment a little bit, just of him showing me my pictures and explaining what things were and what he did. It was really interesting. I thought I would be more disgusted, but I wasn't. I just thought it was interesting. Some of it was a little bit gross, but so he said for me to not try to get pregnant this month. Wait one more month. So next month we can start trying again to get pregnant. And then if I'm not pregnant in 6 months, he wants me to go in and he'll put me on some fertility medication, probably Clomid again. And there was another one he mentioned that I am not familiar with. So I'm excited about that. He said today is basically, well, he said, you know, I'm sorry. Oh my God, do not cry. This is embarrassing because I have to shoot a house after this appointment. So I have to see someone. I don't want to be like mascara running everywhere. But God, hold on. Let me fan myself with my disgusting internal pictures of myself. He said he's so sorry that it took, you know, so long for somebody to tell me that I had this and that I needed surgery and everything. He's so nice. He's the best. But he said fertility is just a weird thing, and you know, sometimes it takes years to kind of know what's going on. And he said now is basically day one for me. Like I'm starting over, and my fertility now is, you know, through the roof compared to what it was. He said that he got all of the endometriosis out. Like everything he saw, he was able to get out, which he said he was so happy with, because a lot of the times he's not able to get it all out, or it's on places where he can't laser it off. Like if it were on my bowels or something, you can't laser it off of there. Anyway, now there's people. I'm gonna get really uncomfortable. It's fine. I have to do this right now. Okay, there's a lot of people. I'm so weird. Okay. Yeah, so he said he got everything he saw. One thing that's really strange that he said was basically all of the endo that he saw was old. There was one kind of fresh new spot, and I guess those look like they're kind of like white little puckered marks. I think I had one of those, and I have a picture of it in here too. He said, but all of my endo was old, like really old, which is strange. Like I could have, you know, I probably had it like as a teenager and then it stopped growing for a while. And then maybe I got a little more and then it stopped. So that's kind of interesting. He said that he didn't see any new, fresh endometriosis, that he had to remove. So I thought that was really weird. I don't know. And he thought that was kind of strange too. And I told him, you know, I've just been doing everything I can now that I've learned about endometriosis to, not everything I can, because yes, I still have days, weeks, a couple of weeks where I just eat whatever I want and don't care. I need to stop doing that. Like the brownies I made the other day. Anyway, I'm just trying to do what I can to really lessen the inflammation in my body. and, you know, eat the right things and keep being active and all of that. But really there's no way to keep endometriosis from coming back. He said that this was like, there was a lot of it. It was moderate to severe, but it was kind of more in a concentrated area. It wasn't like really widespread, which is really good. It wasn't like on my other organs. It wasn't on, my, what's it called? Diaphragm. I thought it was. It wasn't. There's a beautiful picture in here of my diaphragm with nothing on it. I could show you right now, but I won't. So it wasn't on my other organs. It was on, you know, my ovaries. There was a fibroid that he removed. But yeah, there's no way to keep it from coming back. But he said that he doesn't think that it's going to be like rapid growing again for me. So that's good. Okay, what else? I think that's about it. Yeah, those are like the main things I just wanted to get down on film before I left and forgot what he said.
When we go in on from the belly button looking down, we're looking at the uterus, and then the fallopian tubes hang off, the sides, the ovaries are white. On the top of your left side of your uterus was mm-hmm. a fibroid. So you had a little fibroid. Yeah. And so I took that off. I lopped it off, and it's just a benign fibroid.
Okay.
Now, underneath the uterus, this is the deepest part of your body. Remember that mm-hmm. posterior cul-de-sac you talked about? In fact, look, there's some old blood in there, like menstrual blood.
Yeah.
And probably menstrual blood. So when you have a period, menstrual blood comes out the tubes, and it carries endometrial cells, and then the blood sloshes around in you. And lo and behold, it carries endometrial cells. And so wherever that lands, sometimes the endometrial cells land and they grow.
So are you not supposed to have blood in there like that? Or you will?
It's normal.
It is, okay. Mm-hmm.
It's normal, but that's, we think, where endometriosis comes from, is
okay.
retrograde menstrual flow. So blood is sloshing around in here, and it has endometrial cells, and so you start to see, okay, these red spots, these brown red spots,
mm-hmm.
that's these are endometriosis. That's endometriosis. Underneath the uterus is the most common. Here's the rectum, but here's endo right there. In fact, that's a deep-seated nodular lesion. And so,
that's crazy.
In the front of the uterus,
mm-hmm.
Here's a little bit on the ovary. That's the left ovary, had a little bit of endo on it. You know, you can see here some old endo. It's been there a while. It's puckered. It's more scarred, puckered. It can be.
You can hardly even see.
Right.
This one.
But you know it's there. It's probably an old lesion.
Okay.
So that's old endo. That's on the left side. So this is where, you know, you have multiple spots of endo. And
yeah.
It can be a little clear blister, or it can be red or brown or hemorrhagic, or those puckered white lesions too. This is your right tube.
This little thing here?
Had a little tiny, there's the tube, had a little tiny paratubal cyst that I removed.
Okay.
Little tiny dingleberry there. That,
dingleberry.
More endo. This is your appendix. And it's normal. It does not have endometriosis on it, thankfully. This is more endo on the left side. So this is your liver and your diaphragm.
Oh, wow.
So I look up here, and so this is looking up at your right upper, you know, right up here.
Mm-hmm.
Just to make sure.
And there was none there.
Right, I didn't see any endo on
Good.
Your diaphragm. So now I've brought the laser into the field. And you'll see how, if you have an endo spot, I take the laser and I outline the area that I'm going to remove. And
was
then,
that old one you told me about?
That is, yeah, the older spot, I
okay.
think. Multiple spots. These are tubes. The tubes were open. I think I'm flushing dye through the tubes, and they were open. There's some blue dye, so the tubes are open.
Okay.
We kind of knew that, but
I didn't know that. I was hoping.
Yeah, they look like they are, yeah.
Yeah.
But once
okay.
you flush some blue dye through them, then they free flow. So here's just laser excision of endo. The laser's shooting out of here, and here's a big lesion of endo that I'm outlining. And so you can see here's the after. Now the peritoneum is stripped away, and or the areas of endometriosis are cut away.
Mm-hmm.
And so it leaves a wound.
Mm-hmm.
Here's some endo that's been excised. Now we're addressing the right ovary endometrioma.
Okay. I'm real interested to hear about that. I swear I could feel, like, definitely my right side was, like, more painful after the
right,
surgery.
It
like,
should.
I could feel that.
Should be, because the ovaries are tender. This is,
that looks so gross.
Is. Yeah.
What is that?
I think.
Is that draining it?
It's cauterizing the inside of the ovarian cyst. So I strip out the lining, I remove the endometriosis, and then I laser the inside of the endometrioma. So it's a pocket, and it's coated with endometriosis.
Mm-hmm.
So you just vaporize the inside of that.
Right.
And it may or may not reform.
Right.
This can be pretty tender. And fibroids. A lot of women have fibroids, 80%. But this one is on such a perfect little stalk that I could, that I could just cauterize that stalk and pop it off without creating any scar tissue or anything. Now a little bit of adhesion or a little bit of filmy adhesion. And so here's the, there's the before and here's the after. See how that's excised?
Right.
And or where it's deeper seated, I go deeply.
Yeah.
So here are these spots are all excised. It was an optimal excision. The endometrioma, I got it all.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't on bowel or ureter or, someplace where you can't laser. So I'm really happy about that. I'm always happy when I don't have to leave endo on someone.
Oh, that's good.
There wasn't any on the bowel that I remember. This is that one up on by the bladder on the front, up top here.
Mm-hmm.
So that was kind of a deep seated area. That's right on the bladder. And then I put some dissolvable adhesion barrier down. It's like a sheet of this.
Oh yeah, you were trying to tell me about that,
yeah.
And I could
it looks
not
just
understand.
Like, it just looks like a little three or four squares of this.
Okay.
And it's cellulose, and it looks like silk.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like a little sheet, just like this. And you take it and you wrap it around the tubes, wrap it around the ovaries.
How
and
strange.
Put it down against the, so that anything resting against this hopefully won't stick to it, these raw surfaces I create.
Okay.
It usually works pretty well. Adhesions are our enemy, and trying to prevent adhesions is a challenge.
I'm excited. I feel really hopeful. I don't want to cry, oh my god, again! And really good, and like you said, today is day one. Next month is the first month of actively trying again, and he said do that, like time everything right, keep taking my vitamins. He kept saying that, take your vitamins, take your vitamins, take your vitamins, and I haven't been taking my vitamins either, so I need to do that. Give it a good 6 months, six times of trying, and after that we can just kind of go from there. But yeah, my appointment went really good. Oh, and I wore my Footsteps for Fertility shirt, and he commented on it. He's like, wait, what's that? I don't know what that is. So I explained it to him. I can't believe he didn't know what that was, because it's local here. And obviously he knows the fertility doctors that donate the IVF cycles and stuff like that. But yeah, so that's it. I'm excited. I'm gonna go do a bit of work now. I have to shoot some houses. Hi, lady in the background. Sorry about that. Wouldn't that be strange if it was someone I know? It's not. Okay, bye. I almost said I love you, bye. But yeah. Okay.